August 22nd, Saturday, trail day at Tackett Creek. We are going to V-Rock, No Business, Overlook, and Sand Cave today. Coker Knob. There's a small cave area up here with a lot of rock formations, overhang, beautiful little spot. In case you need to cook something you're not supposed to, there's the oven. I'd say that's probably what, probably 10 foot taller.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
Thank you. stop for lunch here after this little climb, hanging out. Just walking around here, got a whole bag of trash. So just a reminder, man, get out there, have some fun, but don't trash this place up. It's terrible. You find some beautiful country and all you do is ride around, enjoy it, but then you pull up to a spot to have lunch and all you see is trash and junk laying around everywhere. So clean up after yourselves. A little harder with the straight shift, isn't it?
Yeah,
like getting it stuck.
I mean, I can't push the clutch all the way in.
What happens if you just like roll back a little bit, like let off your brake and just let it roll back? It might settle down so you can start it easy. Looking good. It's probably going to sit there now. It's rested up against the bank in the back corner. So you might be able to start it now. There you go. There you
right
go.
Down to earth. Good. What now?
Just back up a little bit and like level back out and just get over that way about 2 feet.
Passenger back?
Yep. There you go. Now cut it back, driver. There you go. Keep on coming. There you go. Now you can straighten them up and just come straight on up.
Your left wheel right here.
There you go. Now straight. You got it.
Your trailer, there's a big souvenir you can take home on your bumper.
made it to the entrance of the sand cave, and there's a nice little ledge down here. We just climbed, a few rocks stacked, but Aaron's getting ready to head up. There you go, just give you a little run start. There you go, a little momentum right there, Eric. So we made it to the sand cave, and basically you've just got this big cavern. The floor of sand goes back pretty good ways. And then from the top, there's a small trickle of water, like a small waterfall that comes down and lands here in the middle. And I've been here in the wintertime, and there's been a mound, 10, 12 foot in diameter that comes up 6-8 feet or even taller where the water freezes in the wintertime. Assuming this is what they call a plane crash. There's a remains of a small plane in the woods here. Still in the woods. We are now on what they call Ridge Trail. It's a fairly long trail so far, and it's very tight. So big Jeeps, tight fit. Nobody's gotten any crazy damage, but we're all here just taking a little break and heading back on the trail. We're still on the Ridge Trail, navigating through these trees. I'm gonna go back here and see what Eric has got going on between these trees. Got a tree up against the B pillar here. He's gonna be able to back up. All right, it's past 9 o'clock. I just had to winch out of a big mud hole that I got myself into. Eric's found the other way around. It's another little straightaway. He's given it a few attempts here. Over here where I did, but stayed out of the mud hole, and that proved to be a success for him. And by the way, it started pouring the rain, so kind of feel sorry for Aaron and Eric there. They got half doors and bikini tops, and it poured for a good bit. Thank you. Is he sliding off with his front tire?
Just get the front end of the stick just enough to get him up.
Then he could power through the back.
Yeah, he could get. That's kind of what I would got my tire or my driver up in the leaves right there.
Hey Eric, give it a little, like a little momentum to see if that front end will pop up over it once. Hey Eric, can you tap it out once? There you go, thank you. Tap it again. Keep on going. All right. Hey, let off your brake. Let off the brake. Let it just roll. Keep on going. Looking good. There you go. Help it a little bit with your throttle, just a little bit. Tap it. One more. That's got it. We are off the trail, getting ready to head back on Highway 63. Head back into La Follette and head on back to Knoxville. It's about 10 o'clock.